is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God. Born of his...
Good morning. Let's have a hope devotion one more time. We are continuously studying on the second coming of Jesus Christ and about the all the events of the end times. Bible speaks to us about the future events and also about the second coming of Jesus Christ. In New Testament, for 300 times it is mentioned that he is coming soon. And each book of New Testament speaks about how Christ is going to appear. So Bible is not silent about future, friends, but Bible has a great explanation what is going to happen at finally at the end. And Gospel of Matthew chapter 24 verse 1 to 14, it talks about the signs of the second coming of Jesus Christ and also about the end events, how the world is going to end. So these are the signs which Christ has explained to us. When you read chapter 24, Gospel of Matthew chapter 24, number one, he says that many will come and deceive you in my name, that they are Messiah. And we know that in last 100 years time, many messiahs have come into existence. They deceive people. People, they worship them. How can one human be a Messiah to another human? Both have a perishable life. Only Jesus can save us, and he is the only Messiah. Number two, the sign is that there will be rumor of wars and war will take place. Nation will fight against a nation. And we know in last 100 years time, the whole world has gone into preparation of war, and many wars have been fought, including the two major world wars, where millions of people, they died. Number three, it talks about the persecution of the church. And we know in last 100 years time, church has been severely persecuted. And if you notice, in last 20 years time, church has been brutally attacked. We hear about bomb blast in the church. We attacked about gunning down of believers within the church, be it Sri Lanka, be it Kenya, be it in some African country or even Europe. We find that believers or the followers of Jesus Christ attacked everywhere, and it is intensifying. We read about the false prophets. It says that many false prophets would surface, and they will mislead people. It's very clear, friends, that the number of false prophets have increased in recent years. So now these days, people, they are not much concerned about the eternal life which they can have through Jesus Christ, but they're concerned about their success. They're concerned about their prosperity. They're concerned about their quality of life. So they go to these prophets, and prophet keeps his hands on their head or forehead and prays and prophesies that they're going to get a job in Gulf countries. They're going to have a breakthrough in their life. They're going to have the bank account filled up with the cash. They talk about their marriages, they talk about their success, you're going to have a car in next 6 months time. Prophets in the Word of God are different than these soothsayers and people who do the predictions and these tarot card readers and Reiki people. They are different than this palmist and the mind readers. But prophets in the Word of God, they are people of hope. they would always bring a message of hope at the most hopeless time. The prophet in the word of God, they were the agent of justice of God. They would pronounce the judgment of God to the fallen humanity. And that's what the every prophet does in the word of God. And in the New Testament, same thing is done. When you read 1 Corinthians chapter 14, you find there how a prophet has to prophesy within the church. Prophecy is to edify the church. But here we find the present modern prophets. They prophesy to edify and build themselves up. They seek popularity. They seek respect from the people and they seek money from the people. If any prophet, any man of God, he demands money against his service done, then he is a false prophet. No servant of God, no prophet of God would require money for the service he gives to the church. No, he cannot demand money that you have to give me 10,000 rupees every month or you have to give me 5,000 rupees fee as a registration charge. Never. He's a false prophet. And you know the tendency of false prophets are, they become popular overnight, friends. Overnight they become popular. But next comes is that they have fallen because they are sinful human beings. There's no divinity in them. There's no godliness in them. Never follow a false prophet. Rather, I would encourage you highly to follow the word of God. Because word of God is everything what you need. When you read Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11, it talks about God's plan for you. He says that I, the Lord, I have a plan for you to do good. And there's a hope of the future. You must read all those verses and underline it that my God has already written everything for me. And He's given me the better and beautiful future. Beyond what the prophet of God is speaking to us. No doubt we must honor the man of God, but you must see what he is speaking. If any prophet of God, any man of God, if he runs for the money and the respect, and if he demands some benefits from you, then he is not a man of God. Because man of God's first characteristic is this, that he is dependent on God himself. And he knows that he is just a mediator. He is in between. He is just helping. He is a helper. He is a guide. Nothing else. We got to have a connection with God, friends. Next time, I would like to draw your attention to here it says, verse 12, Gospel of Matthew verse 12 says, and because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall go cold. Because the sin will increase. The sin will increase. Because people, they will become sinner. What of God says very clearly, many will lose love for the Lord. We know, friends, whenever sinful people, the wicked people, they thrive, godly people, they go nervous. There's a tendency. And it's a normal and it's natural that when we see the wicked, they are on rise. So what happens to righteous people? They just go nervous. They're quiet. They see as that something has gone wrong and they're not able to cope up with that thing. And sometimes they lose the interest to be part of the church. They don't want to worship. They don't want to actively participate in anything. Why? Because wickedness is so much everywhere. Let me tell you, if you are really a godly man, wickedness will not destroy your faith and love. Wickedness will never impact your love for the Lord. Love the Lord with all your heart, friends. Another sign is this. When you read verse 13, it says that, but he shall endure unto the end, the same shall be saved. If anyone who endures, who perseveres, who has a patience, who is waiting for the Lord's deliverance, who wants that God may come and interfere in the situation. Okay, what if God says that they will be saved. So this is a sign that if you want to continue with the love of the Lord, then wait with the patience for Lord's deliverance. So when you see the crowd inside the church, huge crowd coming and worshiping the Lord, they are the people who are waiting with the patience for Lord's deliverance. And this is the growth of the church is a great sign that He is coming soon. Verse 14. Gospel of Matthew, chapter 24, verse 14. It says here, "And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness to the nations, and then shall the end come." It says very clearly, when the end will come, the day the message of the gospel is preached to the whole world. The message of the gospel. If you notice, in last 50 years, the preaching of the gospel is intensified. Last 100 years, we declare it as the 100 years of missions. Last 50 years were the season or the years of church planting. And we know in last 20 years time, the evangelism, the preaching of the gospel, the training and equipping of the saint is taking place everywhere. Cities and villages, the most difficult towns, the forest, in the jungle, and the tribes, in the urban areas, in the rural areas, wherever you see, you will find that gospel is penetrating those areas. And we have tons of stories how people are getting saved. We know that all the actors and actresses, they're getting saved. Rich people are getting saved. Billionaires are getting saved. The people from the media, they're getting saved. People are coming to the feet of Christ as never before. We are in the climax of the church planting history, friends. We're in the climax where we see the masses are following. They follow Jesus Christ. Community after community, they're getting transformed. What is happening in your and my time is it outstanding. The gospel is gone everywhere. When it is not gone in 2000 years, in last 20 years, gospel has penetrated all those areas. It's a clear sign that His arrival is at hand. He can come anytime. The question I should ask you today before we conclude, have you done your part? Are you His witness? Are you His witness? Do you share your faith with your friends, with your neighbors, with your colleague, your relatives? Are you just keep your life to yourself and you say that this is my business, I mine? No Christian can be silent. There's no silent Christian. There's no concept of the hidden Christian or silent Christian. But every Christian has to speak. You have a testimony to share. You have a message to share. And you must preach the good news to the people. Let's close our eyes, friends. Father, I commit this time in your hand, O God, Master, as we are learning to be witnesses and we are getting ready for your arrival. I pray in Jesus' name, bless those who are listening and following your word, O God. In Jesus' name, Amen. God bless you, friends. Have a wonderful day.